إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الأحبة في الله، وصية الأولين والآخرين من الأنبياء والمرسلين: تقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى. تقوى الله is the advice and the bequest of all the prophets and the messengers from the time of Prophet Adam عليه السلام until the time of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. What is تقوى الله? Simply make a barrier between you and hellfire. Don't go to hellfire. Adhere to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do what you're supposed to do, and stay away from what you're supposed to stay away from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it when you show gratitude. Even the human being loves it. And in fact, the other day, one person got so angry because someone thanked another person for something and it's not that person who gave him that. Got so angry, he said, I'm the one who gave it to him. And I said, SubhanAllah, the first thing came to my mind is shirk. I said, SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why shirk is so hated? Because it is so injustice, unjust. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does something for you and you go worship something else. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. ظلم تعدي للحدود، تجاوز للحدود. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it when you show gratitude, when you show gratefulness, when you thank Him. He loves that so much subhanahu wa ta'ala to the point He thanked Himself. الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض، الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب. قل الحمد لله. Commanded the messenger to say الحمد لله. The believers say الحمد لله. وقالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله. To say الحمد لله is not just something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. It is something so fruitful to you. When you say Alhamdulillah, whatever you're thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, you keep it and you get more of it. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ أَيْ كُفْرِ النِّعْمَةِ. وليس الكفر بالله سبحانه وتعالى حقيقة. كفر النعمة is to deny the ni'mah and to show no gratefulness. Picture yourself just in a human level, and we're not comparing, but picture yourself, you're giving someone everything. You're paying his rent and you're giving him food and you're giving him drink and you and everything. And then he goes and thank a neighbor or thinks a thank you letter to someone else and doesn't even pay any attention to you. This is wulm. So Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah كانت وصية نوح عليه السلام. The bequest of Prophet Nuh عليه السلام, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في هذه يعني وصية نوح تأكيدا لها, قال سبحان الله وبحمده بها يرزق العباد. And when you say subhanallah wa bihamdih,
we know that this is such a wonderful dua to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while you are indulged in His praise, in His gratitude. You say subhanallah wa bihamdih, with it everything on earth is getting sustenance because of that. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَإِنْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. So everything praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الموت يا إخوان أعظم مصيبة أكيد. أعظم مصيبة في الحياة. لا. أعظم مصيبة في الحياة أن يموت الخوف من قلبك من الله سبحانه وتعالى. When we talk about death, some people think it's the worst and the biggest calamity on earth. But it's not. It is when the khashya or the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disappears from your heart. And you live on إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. You do everything in the book. You live your life like you have no God. You live your life like you are living for this life only. You do nothing for the hereafter. And when someone talks to you or advises you, immediately you say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, and who are you to come and to say this? It's all decorative words that people like to hear. And those who hear it will say, yeah, it's true. Yeah, it's true. Rahmatullah, forgiveness of Allah is great. But how arrogant you can be to expect that when you're not doing anything. This is like someone works in a company expecting himself to go high in ranks and maybe be a partner or be the manager, and he doesn't come on time and he doesn't do his job, and he and you expect that. Who are you to do that? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the person who shows gratitude and loves the person who also worries about their deeds. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Those people who know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watch out for everything. Imagine Prophet Nuh alayhi, Prophet Adam alayhi salam. What did he do? He ate a fruit that he's not supposed to eat. How many fruits you ate, brother? You're not supposed to. How many? You probably go shopping, you pick this and you eat that, and you go on with life and you joke about it, and you laugh about it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him for it. But the day of judgment, when he was asked to intercede, he said, Nafsi, Nafsi, no, I disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he forgave you. It's only a fruit. This is like when you come and you tell a person, brother, smoking is haram. Not just a cigarette. I smoke it every other day here. Oh, well, Sheikh, mixing and parties and all that, men and women is haram. It's once a year, maybe. You belittle the sin, it makes it major sin. This is not how you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is not how you show gratitude. أحد المشايخ يقول, زارني أخ متقدم في السن فقدمت له طعاما متواضعا. One sheikh reporting a story, someone visited him, an elder person, so I gave him what's available, food. You know, some of us go overboard. It's nice to be generous. Hospitality is something high and big, but you don't have to exaggerate if you don't have, and people should appreciate that. فقطع أول لقمة. The first piece of bread he took, قبل أن يأكلها قال سبحان من قسم لنا هذا ولم ينس من فضله أحد. You know, we say بسم الله, took بسم الله, and he said سبحان من قسم لنا هذا. I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who divided this sustenance. وَلَمْ يَنْسَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ أَحَدًا. And he did not forget anyone. Appreciative of what he's eating. It's not top food. It's not five star
meal or restaurant, just average food. يقول اعتقد هذا الاعتقاد. This is what he believes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. What do you have? Name something you have you like. Your eyes, your ears, your body, your car, your job, your son, your wife. Whatever blessing you have, you like, you don't want to lose, it's not from you. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time that you become to confess that and to always attribute your success to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the time that you realize who you are and who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more faqir, the more poor you feel to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the richer you are. The more you feel, oh Allah, I need you. It's not like you have $1 million in the bank, oof, just walk out and leave me alone. I earned it, I did like Qarun did. No, I am so much in need for you, Allah. Dawood alayhi salam, when it rained like locusts from gold and he was gathering, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Alam ubnika an hadha ya Dawood? Didn't I suffice you from this? Meaning you're so rich, why are you worried about gathering this gold? He said, La ghina li an fadlik ya Rabb. I'm never rich, O Allah, from your generosity. I'm always in need for you. This is not greediness. This is need. You're showing need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you feel you are in need, that's when you are strong. When you feel you are poor, that's when you are rich. When you say Alhamdulillah, you get what you want. And you keep what you want, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more of it. So Alhamdulillah, سبحان من قسم لنا هذا ولم ينس من فضله أحدا. This is the first thing that came to his mind. This is the food. What's available? I'm eating. Some people are not eating. This is good enough for me. It's not from me. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This man gave it to me. Alhamdulillah. Thank you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what you have given me. This is how he believed. He believed in something. He believed in وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. Every creature on earth that walks on earth is sustained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every creature. What does that mean? Everything is written. Before you're born. Yes, you can work 10 hours, 12 hours, open 10 shops, miss Jumu'ah prayer and miss Dhuhr prayer, and blame it on Corona and do whatever you want to do. But the day of judgment, you will come and you will realize that you did not increase your sustenance by anything. It's written. You can earn it with 8 hours a day and sustain your prayers and family rights and children rights and people rights. Or you can go work 12 hours or double shift and ignore everyone else, and you're not going to get more than what is written for you. Listen to this hadith. Abu Umam al-Bahili radiyallahu anhu qal, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, inna ruha al-Qudus nafata fi ruhi. Ya'ni awha ila, annahu lan tamuta nafsun, aw anna nafsan lan tamuta hatta tastakmila ajalaha wa tastaw'iba rizqaha. No one will die before the due date. You are written to live 60 or 70 exactly on that time. لا تستقدمون ساعة ولا تستأخرون. Exact time. So don't worry about someone scaring you or the disease is going to kill you. والله يا حبيبي. If you do what you're supposed to do,
taking the precautions and doing your part. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows some people may have legitimate fear and some people may be using it as an excuse. Who knows that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I'm afraid that so many people are taking luxury at home and at work, working and staying away from the masajid. The hearts become so hard and you get used to being lazy. This is how the self come to Fajr prayer for 2 weeks or 3 weeks, it will become a piece of cake every day to come to Fajr prayer, which is the hardest. And skip it one time or two times, three times, it becomes less encouraged for it and finding excuses. So is this how you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is this how you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is this how you want or expect the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's not how we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, your age is written and your sustenance is written. And look what the Prophet ﷺ said, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. Have taqwa. And seek what you want in this life beautifully. Take it the easy way. Don't run after everything and leave what you're supposed to do. No, take it easy. And أَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ, make sure it's halal and make sure it's the right thing. فَإِنَّمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ لَا يُؤْتَى بِمَا يعني بِمَا عَصِي أو إِلَّا بِمَا أَمَرْ. Because مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, what is عِنْدَ اللَّهِ? Jannah and rewards in this life and the hereafter. You're not going to attain it except with what Allah subhanahu what Ta'ala has written for you and by your obedience. Look at one part of this hadith. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّكُمْ إِصْطِبْطَاءَ الرِّزْقِ أَنْ تَطْلُبَهُ بِمَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. Don't get the feeling that, oh, I need $1,000 within a month. It's not coming. So I need to work with whatever just to get it, because I need the 1,000, man. If I don't get it this month, I'm going to lose my rent. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't let that make you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you're going to get it in the right time. And if you do that, you're going to get the sin and it's not going to advance it. But if you have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He'll find you a way out. Well, the other day I was driving and subhanAllah, I have a khutbah actually last week. And from my house to that place is about 30 minutes. And I had 20 minutes. And I know there might be possibility traffic in one lane, so I said I'm going to try another one. I know it's kind of far, I need to have stop signs and lights and all of that. But I said, this is better than getting stuck in traffic. So I took that way. Wallahi, brothers, you're not going to believe this. Almost every signal I came to was green. Only just before I got to Al-Hidayah, two signals right there on I-30 were red, and that like delayed me 1 minute. I was there at 1:30. I was going, subhanAllah, how Allah, so this is exactly how it is. Yes, maybe you need 1,000 at the end of the month, maybe you get kicked out. But you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do? That person will not kick you out. That person will give you respite and give you some time. That person will even forgive you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do anything. You have that. You live good. So say alhamdulillah. Qul qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruh. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي نعمه ويدفع نقمه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. سبحان من قسم لنا هذا ولا ينسى من فضله أحد. Praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى who had divided our sustenance and He doesn't forget anyone. الحمد لله always, always. Listen to this hadith. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله وأفضل الدعاء الحمد لله. The best dua, you know, you can sit and say, oh Allah give me, oh Allah do this, oh Allah do that. The best dua is to say, Alhamdulillah. Because you know what that means? It means thank you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And automatically when you say that, you get more of what you're thanking for. So whatever you're thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it, it's like you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more for it. So brothers and sisters, marriage is written. Work is written. Sustenance is written. Why despair? Why have the stress? Why worry? Why get angry? Why get bothered? Why don't you live your life close with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and attribute all your success to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank Him for what you have? Wallahi, this is the right way of living. This is how you live good and you feel good, and whatever you have, you will not complain about it, because you know it's done. It's done deal. It's there. All you have to do is act upon what you need, but not at the expense of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm not saying everything is written, so sit and it will come to you. No. Go and get it. But make sure when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls you, you're there. Make sure when you hear Hayya ala Salah, it's time for you to drop everything and understand what that means. Come to Salah, come to success. That's what we say in the Salah. Come to Salah, come to success. If you don't, then don't come to Salah, be a failure. That's the understanding of the opposite of that. Don't come to Salah, be a failure. You're a loser. You want to be a winner? Come to Salah. This is exactly how we should live our life. Show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say Alhamdulillah. And the best of all of those things is to know that anything haram you do, it is sustenance, but you chose it the wrong way. If you work in haram for $10 an hour, you could have worked in halal for $10 an hour. But either you did not look or you rushed it. So be confident and live a happy life. Always say Alhamdulillah. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفعنا بما سمعنا وأن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا إنه سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وأقم الصلاة.